Good morning and welcome to Devotion. I'm Mr. Hutchinson. I'd like to start by introducing you to my dog, Lucky. I know she doesn't look like a real wild or lively pup in this picture, but anyone who's familiar with her knows just how wound up she gets when we come home, or when we have visitors over, or when she thinks she's going to get to go for a walk. She goes absolutely crazy. When we first picked her up from the shelter when she was just a couple of months old, we had troubles deciding what to name her. I'm really not sure how or why, but for some reason we landed on the name Lucky. And actually it's turned out to be a pretty fitting name, considering how she behaves when she manages to break free from either her leash or out of our backyard. She really is quite lucky to still be alive, because every time she gets loose, she tears off with reckless abandon, sprinting with her head down, following her nose wherever it leads. And nearly every time she's broken out and found freedom, she is headed straight into the middle of the closest busy road, and more often than not, at the busiest time of day. It's really nothing but the hand of God that my crazy dog is still alive. Given her numerous close calls, Lucky has proven to be a very fitting name, although Providence probably would be more appropriate. We like to celebrate freedom in the United States. We call ourselves the land of the free. But what does that mean? What is freedom? If you ask around, you'll find that there are many different definitions to the question depending on who you ask. But it seems that if you observe American culture in recent years, many people have a similar attitude towards being free as my dog Lucky. Because to many in our country, freedom appears to mean that you are free to do whatever you like, without restriction, without consequence. You say what you please, do what you please, live however you want, or be whoever you want. You're free to seek your own happiness with reckless abandon, regardless of the cost. But there is actually one thing that most will agree upon in regards to freedom. Freedom comes at a cost. In our nation, our freedom has come at the cost of many who've given their lives on battlefields through countless wars. To others, it's come at the cost of those who've tirelessly battled to make sure that the freedoms our Constitution offers are there for everyone. The Bible tells us that we're free too. In our reading for today from the book of Galatians, it begins with these words, "You, my brothers and sisters, were called to be free." We know this freedom came at a price too. Jesus paid the ultimate price for our freedom, true freedom in Him, through His perfect life, His innocent death, and His glorious resurrection. In Galatians chapter 2, Paul notes that we have been spiritually crucified with Christ and joined with Him in His resurrection. We died as slaves to sin and have been raised again to freedom in Christ. This is the true and best definition of freedom. In the United States, the freedom we have is outlined in the Bill of Rights. As believers, our freedom in Christ is detailed in the gospel message throughout the pages of Scripture. Through Christ, our freedom abounds. We have freedom from the slavery of sin, freedom from the bondage of death, freedom from the lies of the devil, freedom from the fear of our past, freedom to enter the presence of our God. It's incredible freedom, but what does it mean for our lives? Does it mean we get to sprint about like my crazy hound with reckless abandon and following our every desire with no concern for the consequences? Probably think the answer to that is no. Of course not. But actually, it does mean that. We have no fear. We have freedom from fear because of Christ. But just because we're free to do that, is that how we should use our freedom? Let's see what our God has to tell us about our freedom through His Apostle Paul in our reading for today from Galatians chapter 5, verses 13 to 15. "You, my brothers and sisters, were called to be free. But do not use your freedom to indulge the flesh. Rather, serve one another humbly in love, for the entire law is fulfilled in keeping this one command: love your neighbor as yourself." Paul instructs us to use our freedom differently than we would have prior to being set free. Much like the current view of freedom that many have in our country today, our sinful human nature would seek to fulfill its own desires once set free. Like a prisoner released who immediately returns to the crimes that led to being imprisoned in the first place, our sinful nature would immediately indulge itself in the sin that led to its bondage. We would follow our noses to our heart's desires. But Paul notes that we should rather serve one another humbly in love. The freedom we have in Christ is not self-serving, because we've been set free from our selfish desires and free to serve our God. As a result of this freedom, we are no longer captive to our selfish human desires. Instead, we are free to live a life of love, genuine love, that puts the needs of others before our own. Love that desires to serve one another humbly, something we are incapable of doing before being set free. Jesus reminds us that the greatest commandments were to love God and to love our neighbors. We see this command of love, to love our neighbor, repeated in our verse for today. Prior to our being made freed in Christ, we were not only bound by sin, but we were bound to the law. Our only hope apart from Christ was to keep the law perfectly. We were enslaved by the law to love perfectly, something we could not do. As with freedom, the word love has many different definitions. But love comes from God, real love. He is the very definition. It's impossible to sit down and read 1 Corinthians chapter 13, the great love chapter of the Bible, and ponder all of the attributes of love without being completely overwhelmed. Overwhelmed by our inability to keep God's command, because on our own and apart from God, true love is out of reach. And overwhelmed by the magnitude of God's grace to us in Christ. Love like this is possible. We have truly been set free to love and free to serve. Christ's love works through us as we display his love to those around us. We're free to love in a way that's only possible through Jesus, and when we do so, we seek to humbly serve one another. There are many who take the freedom as citizens of the United States for granted. May we truly treasure the freedom that we have in Christ and not misuse it, but put it to work in our lives as we love and serve those around us today and every day. Glorious God, I know that not everyone lives free, Many are bound by the chains of sin and enslaved by the devil, the world, and their own sinful nature. Too often I take for granted the freedom that you have called me to in Christ and abuse this gift of freedom to serve only my own selfish desires. Comfort me with your forgiveness and give me opportunities to put your love into practice that I might use the freedom you have given me in Christ to serve others and not seek my own selfish, sinful pleasures. Amen.